Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Betty's Kentucky Derby Race Day Pie. And you might wonder about the hat. If you know anything about the Kentucky Derby, you know that all the women wear spectacular hats, and they can be spectacular in any way. Spectacularly elegant or spectacularly tacky. But mine is pretty plain, so it's just to set the tone for the pie that I'm making. Now, there is a pie which is known as Derby Pie, and there's a trademark on that name. So you will never see Derby Pie on a menu in a restaurant. And I will not call this Derby Pie, so I had the name I gave you before. We'll say this is a first cousin of Derby Pie. What I'm going to do is put this together and show you how it's put together and how it's baked. And 2 weeks from today, when the Derby is going on, if you are close to Kentucky, or if you visit Kentucky, if you have friends from Kentucky, you might have a Derby party and you might decide to have Betty's Kentucky Derby Race Day Pie. So let's get started. We need 4 well-beaten eggs. So I've just taken these jumbo eggs, and 4 of those have gone in there, and I've used an electric mixer to mix those up. Into that will go regular white granulated sugar, 3/4 cup. So it's 3/4 cup of white sugar, 1/4 cup packed brown sugar. So it adds up to a cup, but it's split between white sugar and brown sugar. And the next thing I have is some flavoring. I have vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon that I've measured out here. We'll worry about getting all that mixed in just a moment. Next thing we have is the key ingredient, Maker's Mark whiskey. Bourbon whiskey, 2 tablespoons. See, I'm just about out, but it's not hard to find around here. By the way, I'm not a big drinker, but I do believe in tradition, and if it goes in the pie, then it's going to go in the pie. The next item I have is white syrup. Now, you may have seen light syrup in your grocery store. It's not that. This is called crystal white. So look for white syrup. 1 cup. That goes in. It's all thick, so I'm going to use a spoon here to try to get all of that out. And moving on down, my counter's getting a little messy. Butter is the next ingredient. And I need 1 stick of butter that has been melted. So I have melted it on the cooktop over here, and it's at room temperature now. So I'm just going to pour that in. 1 cup. I'm sorry, it's 1 stick. Sorry, it's 1/2 cup. I will write that up in the recipe, and it will be correct in the write-up. Be sure of that. So we're through with our butter, the 1 stick of melted butter. Then we have flour. It can be self-rising, it can be all-purpose, 1 tablespoon. I've got that measured out. Let's get rid of that. Now we've come a long way down the counter, and we're ready to start stirring this together. Which it doesn't really need a mixer. You just need to have some way of either whisking it or using a spoon to combine. Now let's go to our crust. I decided to use a pre-made pie crust, and you can see this says 2 regular, ready to fill and bake. So to save myself a little time and a little bit of effort, and also I've already given you a method for making pie crust. If you want to go to Betty's Basic Pie Crust Making, then you can see how we make a fresh pie crust. And normally, if I were having company, then I would do that. These that you buy turn out to be smaller than the ones that you make. And that's the reason I'm thinking that I'll make two of them. I'm using the recipe for one pie. So if you have one large crust, then put it all in one pie. But what I'm looking at here just sort of tells me that I'm going to have to split my toppings between the two pies, and with all of this, that would more than fill this and it would run over in the oven. So what I have here is 1 cup of chopped pecans, and I have 1 cup of semi-sweet chocolate. So I'll just show you here. This is what we have for the chopped pecans, and this is what we have for the semi-sweet chocolate chips. So we'll get rid of those. It doesn't matter how these get distributed, but since I'm going to split them between two pies, I'll need 1/2 cup of the pecans in one of these, evenly spread, and then the rest of it goes in the other. And please remember, this is a recipe for one pie, and I'm just making this split so it will come out right, because I can see how much stuff I have here. I did set these two little Pyrex pie plates out. I thought, well, there's gonna be a little bit left over, but when I saw how deep this is in the bowl, I knew that we were gonna need two of these. So I will write it up properly where you can make one pie. But if you need to split it, you know how, by looking at this. All right, the chocolate chips. Again, 1/2 cup goes to each. It's 1 cup, which would go to one pie, but we've got 2 pies. So just spread that until you have used up 1/2 cup, and then go to the other one. The last thing that happens before this goes in the oven is that we pour our topping over it. Could use some of those chocolate chips back here. That's about it. It doesn't have to be perfect. All right, let me stir this around again. And then I'm just gonna guess at this and try to get 1/2 of it in one. And I may come back and forth, but I want it to be blended, so I've gotten down to the bottom and gotten everything. You don't want to have like the solid stuff in the bottom and the liquid stuff floating on top, and so one of them gets the liquid and the other one gets the solid. So here we go. Just pour that out in there, and then go to the other one. Pour about an equal amount out in there. I think we can go back to the first one. And you see how full this is getting. And that's simply because these are small pie crusts. But you get 2 pies, get a lot of servings out of them, and I can put a little bit more in this one. Now these are not going to rise up really high, so it's not a matter of worrying that they're going to do anything abnormal in the oven. I think I will pour this into one of these, and well, actually, I'll take a little bit of that back, and I'll finish this later. I'll put some chocolate chips and some nuts in those, and they'll taste a little better than just having the sauce. So that's my project. I'll take on later. Right now, I'm going to an oven which is preheated to 350 degrees. It's going to take maybe 30 minutes for these to bake. It could be longer than that. I'll check the time, and when they're done, I'll show you what they look like. I want to show you what my Kentucky Derby race day pie looks like. It's nice and rich, as you can see. It almost has the texture of pecan pie or chess pie, something like that. Of course, this was a pre-made crust, nice and crisp. Oops. I would like to say it's a very large recipe, and it's meant for a 10-inch pie plate. Most people have just 9-inch pie plates. So if you do what I did, which is to make 2 pies, you have plenty of filling, and Obviously, I had enough left over without the crust to make these two little dishes as a little sweet treat for after dinner tonight. So I hope you like this race day pie.